Hey y'all, it's Melissa. Welcome to Messy Missy Creates. Here to talk journals. I have been struggling. If you've watched my last couple videos, I've been struggling as to what to do for my November journal. And yes, I know that it's like the 8th. So I need to make one or do something, right? I had this journal, and this was an option, or is an option. And I had made this last November, and I talked in a recent video about just using this one because it was already made and I could just go ahead and start journaling. But I made it last year when all I was using was my plain white paper, and I was okay with that. I was content with that because I inked my backgrounds and things like that. But this year I've been using scrapbook paper, and I have really enjoyed it. It makes my journals thicker, but I've really enjoyed, you know, not having to think about backgrounds as much. And anyway, there's also another reason. And I have this one out too because I want to talk about this one too. This one needs more glue apparently. So this one I did not work in last year, obviously, because it's still blank. It wasn't an extra one that I made. I ended up not journaling for November. So one of my hesitations, and I know that it seems like a waste, but here's one of my hesitations about using this journal. It's almost like a placeholder on my shelf. This was this time in my life, right? I was not in a good frame of mind. Journaling was overwhelming to me, and I respected that, and I just closed it. So rather than me having January through December, missing November, and years later wondering what happened to my November journal, I've just been using it sort of as a placeholder on my shelf. And this is representative of what November was like for me last year. So, okay, so that said, it also has some, I don't want to say negative feelings, associated with it, because it's not that. It's just that it reminds me of, you know, that was kind of it was a little bit of a dark period for me. I don't know how else to say that. And I was really struggling last year, I guess. And though I don't remember specifically what those struggles were, I know that I was struggling, and I know that because this journal is blank, and I remember that I didn't journal last November, and my goal last year was to have a journal for every month. And anyway, so every time I would take this one out thinking I was going to use it, one of you even had a great idea to take the pages out, use the cover, and then just put the scrapbook paper how I want it in here and rebind it. And so I did consider that, and I thought that was a great idea, and I almost did that. But then I go to pull it out, and I don't have warm fuzzies about this journal. I love the paper. I was excited to use this paper, and I love the ribbon. I love the everything about it. And maybe one day I will use it, but for right now, it's not giving me the warm fuzzies. So same with this journal. This was a journal from 3 years ago. It was supposed to be my October journal. And this was right before, if you've been with me for a while, you know that I was paralyzed on my right side back in 2021, in October of 2021. And this was the last thing that I made before I lost the use of my hand. And it was just supposed to be a daily junk journal. And I fell head over heels in love with well, especially the cover paper. But, yeah, it was, but I never used it because I couldn't at the time. And I revisited it in October of this year, or maybe last year, I don't know, and thought about using it. And I'm like, no, it just kind of has those vibes, right? So if we're not in love with our journals, we're not going to work in them. So guess what? I'm making another journal. And I'm using my Triscuit box because that's what I do. Now, next year, I am going to do something different. But for right now, I'm going to keep with what I've been doing this year. And I got up this morning and I said, you know what? I knew I had some new paper. And I said, let me bring in some new vibes. So I flip. Yep. Pretty. Oh, that's cute. Yep, that's cute. Yes. So why not use a piece of paper with a turkey on it for your November journal, right? So that's what we're doing. So I'm going to at least make the cover with you today. So that I can get this video posted today. And I am contemplating doing a live, either tonight or in the morning. When I say tonight, I mean Friday night. So this is what the front of my November journal will look like. And then I had gotten this fabric. I did not use it for my October journal. Did I use it for my September? No, I don't think so. And I think I think it will match just fine. I think it will be just fine. And I think I've already torn a piece off of it and not sure where it is. So I'll probably have to tear another piece, but we'll get to that. It's not ideal. I'm sure I could find something that looks better with this, but it has pumpkins. It's November. It's all good, right? So, I went ahead just for the sake of time. I went ahead and cut down my Triscuit box, and all I do, and I have several videos. You can look in my journal making my journal making playlist. It's called Journal Assembly, I think. And you can look, and I do start to finish how I cut this down. And anyway, so if you want to, you know, if you want to see how I cut it down, just go back and find, well, even last month's video. Let's see. Let me grab my, I don't have to drag out my big cutter because, sorry about my arm in your face. I don't have to drag out my big cutter because we are just cutting paper, not cardboard. And I'm going to cut this down to six, almost said 6 months. I have babies on the brain, y'all. If you haven't heard already, I don't know how you haven't heard, but I'm going to be a great, great aunt. And I'm really close with my great niece. And so I'm just really, really excited for her. So all I do is I cut that in half. I can't get rid of that too far. Because we will use it again. Oh, I need an inside cover. I'm going to use the bottom corner, obviously, because it has the turkey on it. And then I'm just going to cut these down. But what I do is I glue it down and then trim it. Because I just think that's easier. I'm going to get, my glue paper has pretty much had it. So I'm going to get a new sheet or two. So that I don't get glue on my cover. There we go. And I did a big boo-boo. After my last video, I left my glue stick open. Not just overnight, I left it for like 2 days. It still has some stick on it, and I think we'll revive it, but it is definitely, yeah. It's not happy. Not happy at all. But we're going to see if we can convince it to be happy again. And it still feels sticky. It just doesn't. It's really giving me a lot of resistance. So, eek. Hopefully this will stick. Yeah, it feels like it's going to. It's grabbing pretty good. And I think, yeah, it's pretty good. It's not too bad. Not too bad. I cannot find, well, let's see. That's not fair to say because I don't know that I've looked that hard. I do not know right off the top of my head where my bone folder is. Oh, I did find something else I was looking for. Yes. my embellishment wand. But anyway, I'm just going to use my hands. Use your hands. Okay. And then I will trim this down. I left my scissors in the chicken coop. How many of you heard that before? Yeah. Likely story, right? I did. I took them out to just my cheap scissors. I didn't take my good scissors out. These are my good Tim Holtz scissors. I wouldn't have taken these out, but let me close this up so it doesn't get any drier. Okay, so this is not much as far as a pocket or whatever, but it definitely, it still has a little bit of pattern to it. So we could decorate it up or whatever. So it's still going in my little bin over here. And let's do the same thing over here and get this all glued down. And then we can talk about, we can look for an inside cover page or paper. Now, I will tell you, if you're not, if you're new here or you're not familiar with my journals or how I make my journals are about 9 1/4 inches tall. Or nine to nine and a quarter. I don't get very specific with the height. By six and a, my covers are 6 1/2 inches wide. So my papers that I use on the inside, this is my favorite size, my preferred size. My papers on the inside are 9 by 6, or, you know, that's usually the biggest size. And that gives them plenty of room, both top and on the side, to, yeah, it gives me some room to grow. I only do about a 1/2 inch spine, even though I could do more. This one just has kind of a burlap look, and that's kind of neat. It'll be a neat background for a tag or a pocket or some collage or something like that. Okay, now I still have a lot of excess glue right here. And I have a feeling, let me see. I have a feeling I know where my little fabric piece went. I think this basket from when I was making tags. What did I, oh, I know what I used that on. I was like, what did I use that for? I was thinking it was in here with my tags that I made, unless I used it for a tag or something like that, which is entirely possible. Right here. It's right here. Very good. And I'm rolling over ribbon with my... Ooh, that would look pretty with this journal. Kind of. It's more gray than brown, but... Anyway, I'm not going to do this right this second, but... Yeah, that's going to work perfectly. And again, you know, it doesn't match perfectly. It's fine. It's good enough. And, I mean, there's nothing saying I couldn't go ahead and glue that down, right? I'm going to use my Fabri-Tac, though. It already is wanting to stick because there's still that little bit of glue left from the glue stick. Is that going to affect me gluing on my inside cover? I don't think so. I normally don't do this part until after, you know, after I have everything glued on, all the papers glued on, that is. I usually do this last. But now I'm going to take my finger. There's a better way to do this, I'm sure. But I'm just going to take my finger and kind of work in that glue. I need to put more on it. I don't have enough. It's dry right here, and it's drying quickly because I'm thinning it out. Okay. Let's see if we can make this work. And kind of straight too, you know. I like a little overhang on the top and bottom. And so just a little. That Fabri-Tac peels off really easily, so I don't worry too much about that. Okay, I have enough overhang. And we're going to let that dry. I'm going to trim it right about there. And then I have this cute little piece. Maybe I can use on a page or for a tag or something like that. I can see that's not straight. Eek. All right, let me fold it. Shoot. Yeah, that's not. Well, it might have to do. Okay, let me add a little bit more glue because I just peeled it up. I don't like to fold it until the glue is dry. But I can tell that's not straight and not even close. Not even a little bit. So let's do that again. And I know I need my glue further on this side than I had it. I think I'm not going to smear it in this time. I think I'm just going to put it down and hope it mushes together. Let's see. Do we do any better? Maybe a little bit. By the time we get ribbon on it, it will be fine. Okay, I'm going to lay it flat to dry while we're looking at papers. Put my cap back on my Fabri-Tac. And let's look for what we want on the inside. Ooh, I had glue all over my fingers. Okay, so here's the turkey. Let's go back from the beginning. Because I think I know. No, I don't. I was going to say, I think I know what I want. This would be pretty. I'm not going to use something with foil, I don't think. I thought about the squirrels. That would be kind of neat, and it definitely would match. I'm going to keep my finger here. I thought about this one, but there's no green in the cover. To me, that's not fall specific. This would work. So I have squirrels. I have plaid. I mean, that all of these would work, but that would definitely work. I thought about that one for the cover, but we're past Hello Autumn. This would work. I really like that paper. I'm running out of fingers. Let's see. Okay. I mean, any of the... Oh. I might have to use this. I might have to. Cozy sweaters, bonfires, flannels, scarecrows, falling leaves, pumpkins, hot cider... Yeah, okay. I'm definitely out of fingers at this point. That I love that flannel or whatever fabric that is. I love the mushrooms. I thought about that for the cover. And then when I saw the turkey, I was like, nope, we're doing turkey. This is a little redder. I like it. And it certainly would do fine. Oh, I'm skipping pages here. Sunflower. I'm not really digging the sunflowers for November, even though we still have sunflowers growing. That would work. It's just kind of generic. And, yeah. So, again, you're not really going to see this. Right? Kind of like that. I love the pumpkins, but I don't know that I want them for November. I really like this, and I really like the squirrels. I'm liking this tan because that's, let's see. I'm really liking that. I don't know what else I would use this paper for, and I think that has something to do with it. Of course, I don't know what else I would use the squirrels for either. I mean, meaning I'm not going to make a card with it. So perhaps I use it as the inside cover. Now, you're not going to see the pumpkins, obviously, but I kind of like that. Let's use the squirrels, even though I did debate on using the wording one. But honestly, those words I might actually use on a card. So not that I plan on making fall cards at this point. I mean, I could make some Thanksgiving cards, but I haven't made any fall cards at all. So, what do we think? I think it'll be fun. And I like the little squirrels. So we're going to do the same thing with this. We're going to cut it in half. It took me a while to find the dimensions that I like that had the easiest cuts. If that makes sense. I mean, you take a 12 by 12 paper, you cut it. You only have to have one sheet to make the cover and one sheet to make the inside cover. I mean, you can mix and match if you want, but that's really all you have to have. I don't wrap the paper around because then it bulks. It bunches up if you don't let it dry. And it also doesn't fit all the way around because if this is 6.5 and this is 6.5 and you have a 1/2 inch here, that's what, 13.5 inches? So it's not going to wrap and fit. So I like using a little bit of fabric. Fabric doesn't quite bunch like paper does. I'll have to go back and touch that up a little bit. I almost wish I had stuck with something that was kind of in this neutrals, but this look to me looks more like October. Oh, you know what? Part of the problem is I didn't use any of the part that had the brown pumpkins. See all the brown pumpkins in here? And when I held the fabric up to it, it has brown and neutral, and I didn't use the part that had any brown. But it's on there now. It's okay. It's all good. So I'm going to flip this over. Flip my papers over so I don't get any glue residue on my cover now that I have paper on it. And I do have to make sure that this is right side up because this is both are directional papers. Sometimes it doesn't matter, you know, but these both are directional. Okay, so I do have this fold here and I do try to push it in as much as I can with my bone folder usually, but I'm just not gonna stress over it right now. And okay, and if you use thick enough cardstock, you don't see that once you get the papers on there, you're not really gonna see it. So this is drying faster than I can get my paper on here. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing. I only do from the bottom on this one because I can see it better to line it up rather than trying to look way up here. And I put glue over way too far on this one. But that's okay. And I have glue on my paper now, so I need to not get that on my cover. And I'm just going to glue this one down just the same way. And then we'll find some fun washi, or not. I mean, we will. We'll find something that will work, even if it's not fall related. I do have like an orange and brown that might work. I have a brown, kind of a burgundy brown that might look okay. It says Happy Thanksgiving and, you know, those things. I have a thinner one that says Gobble Gobble. But I would definitely want a thicker washi than that. So I will cut it from the top. Okay, so the fabric does get in the way a little bit. I've never done it to where it's going right under there. Okay, that works. So I have this. You can see the two squirrels on it, so that'll make something. And then just start right here. And I'm trying not to cut the cover, but I think I just caught it ever so slightly. Okay. And here we go. This is the one that says Happy Thanksgiving, and it's not really, when you put it up to brown, it looks more burgundy. So I have like this orange and brown plaid, which I really like. And that might work fine. Or, you wanna see what I got yesterday? I got this. I have wanted some grid tape for a long time. It doesn't have anything to do with fall, but I have wanted grid tape for a while. So I might just use that. So it rolled away. It's not as, I'd rather have a darker brown, but I don't think that I have anything that is that darker brown. Here's my like collage washies, or I don't know. I keep these separate for a reason, and I don't always know what that reason is. That one might have been pretty, but anyway, we're going to, and I just bumped you, I think. I'm sorry. We're just going to use this. It's not really going to get seen that much anyhow, so I mean, you can see it a little bit. And I do it right up to that spine edge. And that's how I can do 6-inch papers with a 6.5-inch spine. I mean, with a 6.5-inch cover. I use fabric on the outside and washi on the inside. Here we go. Alrighty. Here we go. That works. I could have also used the black too, but it's on there. It's good. I really went over that one with the... Okay, so I would have rather had... Ooh, I got lots of glue on this outside cover. Or on this edge right here. I would have rather had the brown pumpkins right there. But I think if I do something like this, that will work. Or I, there's too much orange on here. I had one other I was looking for that I had just seen right before I started the video. And well, I could let you look too. Was it this one? It was something like this one. This one right here. I might need something that blends the orange and the brown together. I mean, there's this one that's orange and brown, but I don't like that. I don't like. I have some that has, it's attached to something that's not letting me pull it all the way up here. Okay. All right, I just pulled some of it out. This is orange and brown. It's kind of like an eyelash ribbon. And that would work. Oh, that's kind of cute. How hard is that going to be to glue on? Kind of has the orange and brown. I loved this polka dot before I got on this pumpkin fabric. I really liked that with the turkey. It's kind of, unsuspecting, you know what I mean? Does that make sense? I have a little bit of this brown pom-pom left. I mean, the trims on the pumpkins are brown. I don't know if you can see that on camera or not, but they are. And I can do this right here. It's not wanting to lay down. I don't know why. And I could do orange and brown if I needed to. I don't know if I like that, though. I don't think that the turkey says playful like pom-poms do. Although the polka dots are kind of playful. Yeah, I'm not loving this decision. I don't know, we might have to revisit that part, and then I'll do the ribbon later. I might have to revisit the material and either find a section that has more brown on it, because I think if it, oh, I just bumped you again. I bumped my light and it's attached to the camera. I think if I'd have had this section right here with the brown and this blue more than the orange, I think I would have liked that better. So I might have to cut another piece and glue it over that one. What do we think about that? Are we going to get ticky-tack and let that bother us? Yes, we are. Oh, yes, we are. Let me see. I'm not going to get this. I'm going to try. I was going to say I'm not going to get that whole blue pumpkin in. I'm trimming it down on the bottom. I know you can't see me, but I think this will be wide enough. I mean, and you know, I have plenty of it, so. And I think I could even do this right here. It's got a little bit of the orange. I need to trim off. Let me see if I can pull it off without tearing the paper. No, it is not coming off. But I think, oh, it might. It's tearing the box a little bit right there. No, it's tearing the box a lot. Okay. But it will lift it up enough for me to cut that right there, so I don't have the overhang. That orange bothered me more than I thought it was going to. Let me make sure I got this. Oh, I might not have gotten it wide enough. Oh, it just is. Just barely. I need to re-glue this down here where I just pulled it up. So that it's good and stuck down. Okay. And then figure out what section we want. It got very wrinkled. That has two brown pumpkins. This has two brown pumpkins, so it doesn't really matter that much. I think I can do this like this. Am I gonna like this better? To be honest with you, I don't know. And now that I've cut that, I'm like, eek. Maybe I shouldn't have. Let's let that dry. And then I will revisit that. Okay. Here are, oh, and I did not get, so I'm probably going to stop this video here. It's going to be a short video, I think. Because I did not pull all my book pages. I have my scrapbook papers. So what I'll do is I'll show you what I have, and then I'm going to probably cut them off camera, or most of them anyway. These are some double-sided scrapbook papers that I got a while back from Joann's. They are kind of directional, sort of, kind of. And that one, oh, these two were extras. This one, I don't really care for this side, but if I'm going to use it in any month, it's going to be November, so let's do it. And I have, this is double-sided. This is double-sided. That looks like pumpkins. You've seen that paper the last couple months. That's part of that Flower Girl series. I really loved this with the little forest creatures on it. And this is just kind of a floral, not necessarily fall, but it was part of this set, Forever Fields. So I went ahead and got it. It just had like a grayish blue pinstripe on it. And then this, I thought was pretty, but I really loved this. I wish I'd have gotten two pieces of this. And just some more florals. So let me, I'll cut one down with you, and then I'll finish the rest off camera. And then we will, let me open these up a little bit. I got to cut this branding strip off, so I might as well use the top of this. I'm just cutting it down to 9. So all I'm doing is cutting this little 3-inch piece off or whatever it is. It's a little more than that because it has that branding strip on it. But, yeah, and this is the top of the paper. So we just have this little extra. It'd be a cute little pocket or something. And voila. We fold. Hopefully somewhat straight. You could score it if you want to drag out your scoreboard, but I don't necessarily. I will find my bone folder though. And this is what the paper will look like. So I love this. I love this one. There's two of them that I really love. And anyway, so I will get the rest of these papers cut down, and then I will come back and we'll go through some book pages, because I'm using about half scrapbook page. I need 16 pages total, and I'm using about half and half. Half scrapbook, half like either music pages or old book pages, something like that. More like half junk journal style. And anyway, I'll bring you back for that. Y'all have a great day. Bye.